Produced by Malik.
What is going on, world? Welcome back to Malik's Water Garden. I'm really sorry I haven't updated you guys in the last 2 weeks as much as I do usually. I've been catching up on a lot of personal stuff as well as a lot of cleaning and stuff in the fish room. I had a lot of rearranging to do, so the new quarry rack is set up. An update video is coming up with the new quarry breeding setup. There's 6 tanks that are already set up, and there's 6 more tanks that are going to get set up, so 12 tanks dedicated just for Corydoras. It is a slow process because I do have to move some of the fish that were already in there into new tanks, so I had to set up new tanks and stuff like that. So stay tuned, subscribe if you haven't, and hit that notification so you get updated when that video as well as many other videos like this get uploaded. Also, I got a lot of fish. I got several types of Corydoras and several types of Plecos, as well as a rare Loricariid that is not a Pleco. It's a really small type of fish, and if you guys are following me on Facebook, you probably know already what it is. I highly recommend you guys to follow my channel on Facebook, which is Malik King. I cannot accept all of your friend requests because I get like 200 friend requests a day from different people. So unless we actually have a lot of mutual friends and we are actually in business, I cannot really accept everybody's friend requests, but you can follow me. It is a public profile, and you can watch all the fish videos that I post on my personal Facebook and the public profile. Also follow Malik's Water Garden on Facebook as the page, and Instagram Malik's Fish and Water Garden. So I'll try to update on those as well regularly so you guys can see more short videos. But on my Facebook, I upload these 20-second to 1-minute videos every single day of all the different fry in the fish room. So if you are following me, you know how many fry I have in the fish room. In today's video, we're going to be briefly looking at all the fry in the fish room and all the hypancestrous that I've been breeding. Also, we have hypancestrous zebra eggs, so we got some eggs yesterday, so I'll be updating that as well, and a separate video will be coming up on exactly what the water parameters were and everything that was going on at the time. There's a lot of things that I thought was important, so I measured all the different parameters. So we'll be doing some tests and stuff, and that video will be coming up in a couple of days, so stay tuned for that. Now in today's video, we'll be looking at all the different hypancestrous fry. So without further ado, let's look at some of these Pleco and other fish fry that I have in the fish room. So this guy is my L333 Porter de Mas male. He is in the cave. There are fry in there. I did pull out some fry. They are little wigglers. They are in the container above, so we'll see them in a second. This fry ring contains several different types of fish. So the largest ones are L199 Hypancestrous Furunculus. So we'll see some of those in a second. So you'll see that the bigger ones that you're seeing are L199 Hypancestrous Furunculus. Their smaller ones are various types of hypancestrous. There are some L333 Porter de Mas in here, the yellowest ones that are really small. The ones in between the two are L340s, and there are some L471s in here as well. I just don't have enough breeder rings. I have my, I think, 4 in total, and 3 of them are now full of fry, and I have the 4th one in backup for my L46 hypancestrous zebra fry. So that's what's going on. This fry ring houses mostly L471s. There's several batches in here. If you can see, I don't know if you can see, but there's a bunch on the oak leaf. I'll try to get them off so you can see them better. And they don't really like to come off the leaf. They are camouflaged on this leaf quite well. So they really like hiding on the leaf. Try to remove the leaves for you guys so you can see them. See how many fry there are? Here. There we go. So these are all L471 fry, and there's, I think, 1 or 2 L340 fry in here, and that's about it. There's nothing else except there's a nice L340 right there. You see it? Right there. So yeah, all my nice ones that I like to want to just keep an eye on, I put them in here. So that's that fry ring. This fry ring houses L199. There's about 50 to 60 of them in here. It's actually from one male. He managed to get these 2 clutches of eggs in one go, and I lost about 2 or 3 when they were hatching, and since then the rest are all surviving and they're doing great, and they're all in there. I just what it is, they are getting moved into their own tank in the next couple of days, and all right, you guys can see some that have jumped out. See? All right, get back in. You too, back in, back in. Get back in. Come on. All right, you gotta see this. See this right there? That's how you lose fish. You gotta make sure that none of them are doing that. So, yeah. There's another one here. Come on, back in the tank. They are quite smart. And they can jump out if they want it. So, plecos do jump. Try to catch some of the fry in the tank, actually. So, if you can see right here on the cave, right there on the cave, that's the L199 fry. I'm actually holding him. There's about five or six of those guys in this tank that look really nice. So I'm kind of having them in this tank so I can keep an eye on those guys. There are a lot of fry in this tank. You guys can see some of them. There's one right there. You see it? There's a few more up here. I don't know if you can see them. There's a shrimp right there. There's a bunch of fry. There's one right on this cave here. Let me try to zoom in on him. So there's about 20 fry in this tank. I just can't get them all on picture because they're always hiding. But if you do look at some of the videos or if you follow me on Facebook, I do post this tank quite a bit. And an update is coming up on how active plecos are during the day. I think the whole concept of the whole notion that plecos are nocturnal and they only eat with lights on, lights off, and that they don't eat during the day, they're not active during the lights on time, is total bogus. Look, I'm standing right in front of the tank right now, and my fish is right there. See my hand? See the fish? See, he just ran because I tapped on the glass, but if he didn't, like, look, see? They're very friendly. I'm, like, right in front of the tank. See? My hand is right there. See? She just moved. So, yeah. So that update will be coming out, so stay tuned and subscribe if you haven't. Same thing with this tank as well. There's about 20 or 30 fry that I haven't caught yet and that are smaller that were born since I moved all the fry out. This is my L340 breeding group and some L134 growths. And there are fry underneath these slates and stuff. I'll try to put some B-roll of those guys as well. And but it's when you look in the tank, you barely see any fish actually. Unless, like, you know, I'm feeding them and they'll all come out. But you can see all my plecos are out and about during the daytime. This is lights on right now, and they are all looking at you, looking at me, and you know, everything is good, everything is normal. They're not hiding. So that whole concept that your plecos are always hiding is not true. But yeah, moving on. This tank houses mostly L340 fry. There are some other L471s and various other hypancestrous in here, just the one or two odd ones that just based on size and stuff. You can see some of the fry here. I'll try to get some out for you guys so you can see them better. They are usually on the filter. Here we go. I don't know if you can see that, but see? Can you see that? Some pretty ones. This one's really pretty. Anyways, let me reset that again. There are a lot of fish in here, but you rarely see any of them because they're always hiding. There's some right there. There you go. There's one in here. Yep, see? And yeah, so this is a grow-out tank. I have a few of these, but I'm not gonna go through all of them because you can't really see anything except dirt and whatever I can put out. I just want to add these in the video. These are some of my angel fish. These guys are a few days old. About a week, I would say, out of the, looking at the size, about 5 days now, actually, now that I think back. They're about 5 days in this container. I do change water in here every single day. There's several hundred in here. It's hard to count them in, like, when you look at it like that, but, I mean, look, it's like sand. And then these are the ones that are older. So these guys are about a week older or 2 weeks older than what you just saw. And so let's try to zoom in. Look how many there are. And they are afraid of my hand. So I can corral them however I want, so it's easier for me to clean. I clean this every day as well. Down below I also have some fry in here, but these are tetra fry, and I just want to show you guys. There's a whole bunch in there. I just, see? So all my tanks do have a fry. I'm not gonna go through every single one, but like when I'm doing video updates and you guys are looking at the tanks and you don't see much,
It's because the fry are usually hiding. So if you look at here right now, you don't see a lot of fish, but look at that. There's about 50 fish in here. These were all born here too.
I will be doing a complete video update on the Hype Ancestral Zebra eggs. You guys can see a B-roll footage of that right now, but we'll be looking at that in a complete separate video. So if you haven't subscribed, subscribe and stay tuned for updates. This is just the first clutch of many. We have over 200 Hype Ancestral fry in the fish room right now that are not zebra plecos, and I'm expecting some zebra plecos this year. I'm probably gonna get a bunch of different zebra pleco fry, hopefully. God willing, that's the plan. They are trapping again. I did get a second trapping. I'll put some B-roll of that as well. But we'll be looking at that in complete detail in the next video coming up. So stay tuned. And as always, thank you so much for your love and support. I'll see you on the next video. God bless you all.